Guys, the dog days of summer are almost over. August 11th, I've written it in my journal so that I can celebrate that day. Hi, I'm Jennifer Ogilvy, and I'll be your facilitator this morning as we set up our week. It's going to be the first week of August tomorrow. July just really dragged, it seemed. It was a long 31 days. I'm just glad to welcome you. You have Team Jennifer on today's call. My co-facilitator is Jennifer Krippner, who's coming to us from Minnesota, and she is going to be working in that chat. So if you have any questions as we go along this morning, drop them in there. And if a song's playing, I can jump in as well, but she will take care of you, get you the information that you might need, and support our journey this morning. So a fun fact about today, happy birthday to Harry Potter. So without Googling, anyone want to venture a guess how old Harry Potter would be today? You can drop that in the chat. Just a little fun time. Okay, 32. Rachel says 43, 40. Okay, we have a winner, actually. Carol guessed Harry Potter would be 43 years old, which makes me ancient today. Yeah, I know, Rachel. I just thought that would be a fun fact, a little factoid to start our time together. I can remember standing in the grocery store line at midnight when the book section would release the Harry Potter books, and my kids would be waiting with their allowance to buy their very own copy. Another fun fact about this is J.K. Rowling's birthday is also today. So she gave her Harry Potter the same birthday. Now, different year. J.K. Rowling is about 15 years older than Harry Potter, but just kind of a fun factoid for the day. And I'm sorry if I broke anybody's hearts with how old Harry is. Like I said, I feel ancient. So let's get going with our day. Now, just a quick reminder, let's make sure that your chat is set to everyone so that we are able to share together this morning. I want to remind you of our community guidelines. You see them there. Basically, they say this is a safe space, a safe place for you, and a safe space for your fellow Sonder family, and we just plan to keep it that way. And also a reminder to always take care of you. And if you are ever working on a prompt and you're just not in the headspace, we grant you permission, give yourself permission to sit back and just lean into it later when you are a little more able to handle some of that deep digging that we do. Now, I am very excited to introduce our new theme this month, the theme of tranquility. I'm a big fan of these journals because these monthly themes really help us dig in to knowing ourselves better, right? When we explore kind of, you know, our life's journey and where we're going through these different lenses, we really do get to know ourselves better. So I'm very excited about embracing tranquility with you this month. So our agenda this morning, for those of you who are new, it's pretty standard operating procedure. You'll see this format at all our weekly setups. We're going to work on our tranquility mind map. I'll tell you a little bit about that. We're going to do a rosebud thorn reflection from last week. We're going to kind of look at our week. We're going to do our weekly setup, and then we will close. Now, if you are brand new here, please let us welcome you. Drop a me in the chat right now so that our Sonder community can give you a big welcome. I know we had a couple who dropped that. Yes, Bridget, I saw you at the front end of our time together. Kim, welcome. Chanel and Lauren and Allison. Oh my goodness. Shauna. Shauna, set that chat to everyone so we can see what you have to say. Oh my goodness, from Indonesia. Okay, well, Yadina, you get the award for the longest distance. I'm so glad to welcome our newest members of the Sonder community. And I will tell you that these setups, the monthly setup and the weekly setup, you know, you will get a cadence to your journal and how you set things up to work for you. But keeping this appointment with yourself, oh, it's a great way for that self-accountability to exist. So you're going to see a lot of ideas dropped in the chat this morning because we do share as a community. I have lots of examples that I was able to snag from our Sonder Club app. And we just do a lot of sharing, a lot of setting up, and we keep that commitment to ourselves. So that's the beautiful part about these setups. So let's start with our tranquility mind map. Now, we will be doing 5 reflections this month. So when you look at July, it's about that August, 5 weeks long that we're going to be digging into tranquility. And so I set my mind map up like this. I went to a notes page, but you could do this on the quote page, which is on page 38, the definition page that's got the definition of tranquility in it. You could use the weekly scratch pad and grow your mind map on those weeklies, that little side scratch pad. You could do sticky notes. You could do a whole nother space, like your thoughts journal, where you collect these ideas. So, Crystal, thank you. Yes, Crystal is saying sign up for the Coloring Social. Actually, August 2nd is National Coloring Book Day. And so we're kind of really wanting to embrace coloring on that day. So I would love to see you there. I get to be the facilitator for that. I've got a lot of chill music. We're going to find moments of tranquility in that practice. So if you haven't tried it, please, please come. I'd love to see you there. So I set my tranquility mind map up by using my driver's license, and I traced 5 spaces, 1 space for each week's reflection. So we, at every weekly setup, no matter what day the setup is on, we will be grabbing onto a certain lens to look at tranquility in our lives. All righty. So I hope that makes sense. And yes, the boxes are great because that driver's license or credit card is the perfect size to create that. So that's just my helpful hint for your mind map. So we are going to explore how we can embrace this sense of tranquility in our lives. And this week, our first week, has to do with our thoughts. And I just want to shout out to one of our other facilitators, Maya. She creates these slide decks or some of the graphics. We build our slide decks as facilitators, but she made this graphic that I love. And our first week is going to be thoughts. And the question for us to consider through that lens of tranquility is, how can acceptance of things and people in your life lead to more tranquil thoughts? And when I read that question, the first thing that came to my mind is that graphic of the circles of control, and the reminder of I have full control over some things and partial control over some things. And honestly, there are things in this world I have no control over. And so I owe it to myself to frame those things out, to be able to handle them, right? To embrace them and accept them. Acceptance was July's theme. And so when I started thinking about that, I said, acceptance to me equals being happy and content. I can embrace challenges. And I said, stay in my lane, right? Remember, I don't need to go looking for trouble. Stay in my lane. I give myself power. There is power in accepting the things that I cannot control. And acceptance allows me to focus on my mindset, my behavior, and my words, the things that I do have control over. So I'm going to let you sit with this thought. I'm going to play some music and feel free to drop some of the things that might be bouncing around in your mind as you consider accepting the things and people in your life. And if you're looking for that question, I actually wrote it in week one on my page. All righty. I'll check back in with you in just a few minutes. All righty. I love that there is a little discussion about thinking of in the circle there about others' opinions of you and that you have some control over. And some of you are disagreeing with that. And others of you are like, well, maybe there is a little bit, you know, I can own with my actions. Yes, we can't really control what others' opinions are, but also somebody mentioned, you know, if I come in with a sour face all the time and I'm just intentionally grumpy, then, you know, maybe I am influencing others' opinions of you. This is neutral, and I'm excited that you guys are kind of thinking about what that means in your life and how you frame that out. So thank you for taking a moment to begin our weekly reflections through this mind map. And I love that those brains are firing this morning. Good job, my friends. So let's do our rosebud thorn reflection. Now, if you're brand new, you will find a rosebud thorn space at the end of every single week that we have. And so if you don't have July, you might want to do this on a scratch piece of paper, because we generally do it at the end of the week to kind of look back on how things went. I didn't do my graphic right. Yes, I did. So if we're in July, we are on page 56. If you're wrapping up that week, this midweek thing or mid change gets me off. Or you can use a blank space in August, or a scratch piece of paper, or, you know, whatever. So when we look at a rosebud thorn, we are reflecting back over our week. What went great? What is a highlight, something you're proud of, maybe an accomplishment or something that brought you a lot of joy? That's going to be your rose. And a bud is like an emerging opportunity. What might be presented in your life that is something that could be kind of this new opportunity? And sometimes my bud is just, it's a new week and I'm going to embrace that. I could kind of get a fresh start or a new month. And then a thorn, of course, is a challenge, something that was thrown your way, something that might be an ongoing challenge, like some medical things. So, you know, there's power in putting this on paper and claiming it and calling it. And so for me, I got to have an extended keep my grands last week. I had them for 3 days. And so that's my rose, but also my thorn, because I am very tired. It's a 5-year-old, a 2-year-old, and an 11-month-old. And this Jojo, that's my grandma name, is tired. And then my bud is, this is our 40th anniversary month, and we are planning a little getaway to the Gulf Coast of Texas, which is actually home. That's where we raised our family, on the Gulf Coast. So we'll be down in the Houston area for a couple of days in August. So I want you to do your reflections on this past week. Drop them in the chat. Let us give you some love for those thorns, and let us celebrate with you your roses and your buds. Thank you. I was busy reading in the chat. And I missed my cue to come back on camera. Thank you for being vulnerable and sharing some of those thorns. You know, we know life is life, and we're going to have both the good and the bad. And sometimes the thorns feel so overwhelming. So those of you who are going through something that's ongoing, health issues, maybe some financial things, we do hold space for you, and you will find support in this community. So if you have moments where you just feel alone, remember you've got us here, just embracing you and holding space and lifting you up. And congratulations to all the wonderful roses. I'm real excited for Jen K because she's joining the Grandma Club sometime this week. And I just, you know, if you know, you know, it really is, indescribable. And yes, my 40th anniversary is this weekend. I thought I'd just share with you. My husband will tell people we've been happily married for 27 years, and people will go, "Oh, that's awesome." He's like, "Oh, well, we've been married for 40, but we've been happily married for 27 years." He's always the comic, but I think it's his way of saying, you know, there are peaks and valleys. It's not like it's an easy thing. So I always like to keep that in mind. You know, peaks and valleys, life has ups and downs, roses and thorns. So let's get going with our weekly setup. Now, I want to remind you, this is your journal. If you're brand new here, you're going to see all these spaces, and it might feel a little overwhelming. And what we're going to do today is look at these spaces, look at ways to use them just as they are in your journal, or give you ideas to kind of repurpose the spaces to work in your life. So lots of slides are going to have examples. So grab a screenshot or grab your phone and take pictures of things that speak to you. When I first started using my journal, lots of post-it notes. I never committed during a social, right? I would take post-it notes and kind of pencil in what I wanted to do. And then I would sit later and start structuring these pages to work in my life. They were a lifesaver for me. I was an early retiree, and I lost all the structure from being a school administrator to no structure. And this helped me. My journal was a great tool to rebuild structure that was just missing in my life. I wasn't getting anything done, and I had all this time in it. For somebody who's productive, I was really having some conflicting feelings about being retired. So give yourself some time to figure out what works for you. What's your cadence? Also, it is fun if you've been using your journal, you know, week after week after week, it's fun to change things up every now and then. So I have a huge list here of just things that you could put in these spaces. And then I'm also going to share with you some graphics from our wonderful Sonder family. So make it work for you. So this week we're working on pages 26 and 27 in our August calendar. It's week 31 of 2023. And this is actually my setup this week. I'm ready to go. Thought I would just let you see what my pages look like typically. I'll point out in the mind body health plan, when we get to that, I'm going to actually use it this week to lean into life in the five senses, which is the Gretchen Rubin thing about noticing our senses and finding maybe where we're lacking. We will share those links with you so you could go back and watch the fireside chat between Gretchen and our founder, Meha. It was wonderful, and it's a lot of fun. But I was telling Jennifer when we were going through my slide deck before we met with you, I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do in that box, that mind, body, health, but it's going to be something with those five senses because I was so influenced by last week's fireside chat. My major three goals there, I have fun, frog, and fruitful. And that means I'm going to do something fun. the frog or the, it's like the eat the toad, eat the frog, the things I don't want to do, but need to do. And then fruitful is just something that's very productive. That's going to kind of, have benefit to me. And so the way I did it this week is I actually made a little bingo board over there in my shopping list, and row one are all the fun things I want to do. Row two are my frogs, and they're mostly cleaning. And row three is my fruitful, my jobs, that I want to do. One of them is update the August budget, plan my August menu, start working on my fall garden. And then my fun things are I do Post Crossings, which is a postcard exchange. It's a site you can go on. So I want to send a postcard. I want to leave a quilted heart, and I want to watch a movie, and I want to set a lunch date with a friend. So kind of my bingo board is going straight into those goals. And then my habit and activity tracker is there. My weekly to-dos, that box becomes a ta-da box. And I like to celebrate the things that are not on the to-do list, but I want to give myself credit for doing it. And there's just power for me in writing that in my ta-da area. So that's kind of what my weekly setup looks like. Let's take a look. Now we're going to break things down and go through your pages so you can get set up. So the first thing I want to ask you is think about the week you have coming up and how do you want to feel this week? And drop that in the chat. Let us know how you want to feel this week. And I said, I want to feel engaged with my senses. So it's going to directly connect to that mind-body health that I have, lovingly aligned. Ooh, I like the way that sounds. Accomplished, back on track, light, in control. Shannon, I'm going to share some more information about that frog fruit. Anyway, present. You want to feel like you've reset, mindful. You know, August is a big transition month. And normally for me, I'm a retired educator. I would have never paired tranquility with the month of August, because it's just, even if you're not in education or you don't have kids, you're getting ready to go to school. There is something about this transition. It's like goodbye summer, hello fall. Our media is, the back to school and the sales, and there really is a reset. And so I find it so interesting to think about August paired with tranquility. I think it's going to be very fun to explore, because my head has always been trained that August is anxiety. So it's going to be good for me to lean into that. So you guys, progress, not perfection, tranquil structure. Yes. So think about that for the week, what you want to do. And then I'm going to ask you now, when you think about how you want to feel, we're going to think about the goals that we're going to set, because your goals should hopefully leave you with that feeling. So that's kind of always my question, is how are those goals going to support that feeling? And we have a space here for three major goals, but I'm here to give you permission. You can add if you need to add, and you can take away. If you've got a crazy week, maybe there's one biggie that you need to focus on. So you look at your week and do what's right for you. Lots of ways to set this space up. Go back and look at those monthly intentions and the habits that you have. Those could directly jump into your goals for the week. Set your goals through that lens of tranquility, maybe really leaning in to this week's mind map. Create no goals. What are you going to eliminate from your life that's not serving you? Go look at maybe previous weeks, previous journals, what's outstanding, what do you need to tackle? Frame your goals around a challenge, a personal challenge, maybe how you eat, rest, your health. I know somebody put that as their word. They want to embrace their health. And then the three categories is a great way to set this up if you're kind of stumped on how to come up with your goals. And that's, I'm going to show you lots of examples of some of these things. Delete, delegate, delight, left brain, right brain, no brain. So let's take a look at those. The first slide you see there on the left, someone has set their goals or setting a goal for God, for job, and then to detach. And those things will help this person feel present. There's a mind body work in the middle. Celebrate, that was the word. And then they brought that down into their goal, health, family, vacationing. You guys, and I will play music and go back and forth between these slides. Again, just a 1, 2, 3, eat well, stay active, self-care, and then kind of gave some ways they're going to do that. There's that delete, delegate, and delight in the bottom middle. And then the mind, body, spirit, mind, body, heart. I love the week. You can see this person under motivated put 4 things down. So again, making the journal work for you. There's that left brain, right brain, and no brain. It's kind of the things that you just go along with. And then I don't have my example up, but my frog, fun and fruitful, I will drop in the chat while we work on this. So let us know kind of what you're doing. I'll come back and check with you in a few minutes after you've worked on your remaker goals for the week. Thank you. So now that you've set your goals, let's take a look at our to-dos for the week. So that's going to be that box that's a little bit over to the left of our goals. Now, there's lots of ways that the Sonder family sets this space up. Again, I leave mine blank and it becomes ta-das for those things that are not on the to-do list, but that I get done. But the Eisenhower Matrix is a wonderful tool. We bring this up every single week. If you have a huge to-do list and you're feeling overwhelmed, go plug those things into an Eisenhower Matrix, and that will help you prioritize. I know when my list would be really long, I would tend to gravitate to the easy stuff that probably should have been deleted and not prioritized to the important and urgent stuff, because I had that overwhelming feeling. And this is a great way to address that. Here's some fun ways to set up that to-do list. Now, please notice the upper graphic over kind of on the right, the three goals this week: balance, budgets, bylaws, and then the to-dos for each one of those goals are written over to the left. So they're actually broken down. I love the flower graphic that we've been seeing from one of our Sonder family members. It just makes it a fun way to, it's almost like a little bingo, and you can color in that flower as you accomplish those things. You can divide this list up into work or home, morning, evening, those things that will serve you, and you can repurpose the space. Lots of people make it a bingo board of to-dos. Now, I want to encourage you, if you'll notice the bingo board that's here, there are some, and I do the same thing on my bingo board. You've got the to-dos, but make sure you're putting some fun things in there, some things that will offer you some self-care and some moments that bring you joy. This person added in, you know, a mask and nails, or soaking in, you know, a bath. So make sure that you are creating balance in your life. The graphic at the bottom middle, how do I want to be this week? And then sometimes, what do we need to take away? Make a list, a not to do list, right? What do you need to take away that's not serving you? And then I want to also, let's look at that habit and activity tracker that's just below. And then I'll go back through all of these slides so that you can have time to work on both of these sections. The habit and activity tracker for the week is going to be a little different, maybe, from your monthly. So that big monthly habit wheel, we like to kind of put the things in there that we plan to do every single day during the month. Things like make your bed, take your vitamins, the things that you might, you know, need to do, but you're not paying attention to. A lot of times I'll put sunscreen on mine. This month, because of my terrible bedtime habits, I actually have put two of my habits in the monthly is, you know, 30 minutes before I get out of bed in the morning and 30 minutes before I go to bed at night, no phone. And I am making sure I am checking that off. I'm trying to build in some accountability for that, because I've got that silly phone and I'm wrecking my bedtime. But one of my activity tracker things for the week is go check the monthly tracker so that I'm seeing it and it's reminding me to go to that page and be accountable to myself. Now, these spaces don't all have to be filled in. Just do what you want. You don't need to have overwhelm. This is to set yourself up for success. So maybe you're going to track three things like the one you see in the middle of the left side of this graphic, just a few things. Also, you notice the one in the upper middle, they're going on vacation or something, taking a long weekend and said, nope, I'm not tracking. I'm going to lean into whatever's happening that Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So just, it's a reminder to give yourself that, that grace and that time. Make this section work for you. It's neutral. It should never make you feel guilty because you didn't get something done. You can set a goal to track how many times you want to do it. You see that. But also, some folks just track. And so look at the one in the bottom left there. They're going to just track with those colors. They're not setting a goal. They just kind of want to see what they do. And then other folks will just circle the days that something needs to happen. So you can see the middle over on the right look like laundry day. That's going to happen Monday and Wednesday. I take a medication every third day and I forget which when I've had it. And so I actually circle the days for that medication. And it's just a great way to track that. So, I'm going to share lots of ideas. If you're not sure what to put in this space, let's work on this and I'll come back and check in on you in just a minute. There's a little discussion. Yes, this is being recorded. And at the end of the social, we're going to share that link so that you can access, any of the setup, weekly setups, monthly setups, any of the socials. It is a private YouTube channel, so it's not searchable. So when you do get that link, save it as a bookmark. Now let's pop over to page 27, and I'm going to go through all of these spaces with you, give you a ton of ideas, and then I'll get off the camera so that you can work on all these sections. So the meal plan section is probably the most repurposed part of our journal each week because they've just got those good juicy boxes already put in there. Now I use mine more of a food tracker. So I write down what we've eaten so I can track those leftovers. It's just my husband and I, we will go, you know, when did we have the enchiladas? So it kind of tracks there. But here's a lot of just different ways you can set this menu meal plan up, symptom tracker, daily debrief, again, a ton. You can see so many ways. I love the journal prompts and responses. The prompt is on a post-it note and you flip it over to do a quick response to that. Wardrobe checking, just a regular checklist. Lots of great ideas. 7 types of rest. Now, the 7 types of rest, there's a quiz that you can take if you just go to the Silk and Sonder website, and you can find what type of rest you need and lean into that one type of rest, or you can set that up to do something for each area that will benefit you. What a great way to lean into tranquility as we look at rest in our lives. So again, a great space to repurpose the mind, body, health plan. I had mentioned that this week, mine is going to be embracing the Gretchen Rubin Meha fireside chat and just really leaning into my senses and noticing things. Jen just posted the 7 types of rest quiz there. Yes. And I loved these 2 graphics because the simple self-care is the way to lean into 5 senses in a very simple way. Look at something nice, smell something nice, feel something nice, listen to something nice, taste something nice. It's about stopping and noticing. And then there's a grounding technique on the graphic to the right that you may find beneficial. So that this kind of stuff is what I'm putting in my mind, body, health plan this week. Here are some other ways to set that space up, to repurpose. Exercise. Again, a lot of self-care. This space tends to be the physical self-care or the mental self-care really being determined to make sure it happens by having that power of pen to paper and committing to yourself, making a date with yourself. Look at that one in the upper middle. It's a tranquility meter. So really leaning in each day to how they're feeling. She's going to do just a little graph, like a bar graph, on how tranquil her day was, how this person felt. Track Wordle, feels and needs. I love, how did I nourish my mind, body, soul? So many great examples from you all. And then again, the shopping list, another great space to repurpose. I keep a virtual shopping list that I share with my husband. So I use mine as a bingo. You can see those examples over there. A lot of great ways to reframe this. I always love the one, stay out of the store or get off of Amazon as your shopping list, but lots of different ways to set these little graphs up. I also love this social check-in, being very mindful of checking in with the people in your lives. That's there on the bottom left. And then what are you loving right now, this very moment? This week, my space for I am loving is Barbie. I went and saw the movie. I want to encourage you to go. It's silly, but it's also so meaningful and a lot to unpack about what it is to be a woman. So highly, highly recommend. Let me put on some music, go back and forth through these slides so you can tackle this page, and I'll be back to check in with you.
Thank you.
my friends, our time together has come to an end. It always goes so fast. And I tell Jennifer, I always talk too much. I get so excited about all the ways we can set up our journal. Here are some images of how people set up their week. I'll go back through those as we play our closing song. Please share your weekly planner, anything that you are loving. Take a snapshot of that and stick it in Sonder Club to inspire one another. Here are our refer a friend code there on the left. And then the feedback survey is there on the right. You can use those QR codes. You'll also be receiving a email following this that will allow you to reference those things. Jen has dropped all the things in the chat, all those links. Save that YouTube link so you can rewatch. And then there's my song list. I'll drop that in. Thank you. Have a great week. The dog days of summer are almost over. I'm so glad you chose this time to lean into your self-care and set you up for a fabulous week of tranquility. See you next time. On my Cadillac, try to call the body shop, but my phone is dead. I tried to email my brother, but the Wi-Fi's down. The stuff is haunting me all year round. I'm fixing one thing and another one's coming loose. It's making me think how much this makes. Ooh. I keep on buying new things that I can't really use. If it gets you annoyed, then what is the point? Don't need no TV, I don't need no phone. Don't need no speedy car to get me home. Don't need no nothing, all I need is time for that simple life. I'm taking one step forward and three steps back. I kick myself for letting go all the things I had. I guess you don't know what you got till that junk goes bad. I never should have dumped that hand-me-down I got from. Solve one problem and another one's popping up and